Writing skills, the teaching talent, and also the very good amount of patience dealing with all the paperwork to wade through to get the Fulbright neighborhood grant, as well as putting a lot of the financial things in order so that we can come here and we can, when we get back, we don't have a lot of legal problems because we haven't been doing this. So there's two things that happened. First of all, I've always wanted to come to India, and but I never did anything about it. So when Rebecca had this, she won a grant for her writing for the state of Massachusetts, and we were telling a friend about it. And the friend said, "Oh, now that you won that grant, why don't you apply for a Fulbright?" So this was in the beginning of June, and the deadline was middle of August. So as I have it in my memory, she just kind of turned around and went upstairs and started working on the computer. Our computer is slow, so she had to fight through all the paperwork, the reams of paperwork, fill out the forms, and all I did was cheer her on. So I see this thing as this coming to me as a total gift, just a gift. But as I told friends about that we, once we had gotten the grant, that was coming to India, there were two things that came up. Oh, India, there's so much poverty there. And the other was, a friend of mine said, you know, you really won't know about, he was quoting some writer, so I said, you only know about your culture from the eyes of another culture. And I had heard that before, I had traveled abroad before, so I had some indication I knew what it was like. But believe me, coming here, in this spot, being here, oh, by the way, I also want to thank Dr. Sangal for encouraging us both to come. We would have slid through the cracks, we would not have come, but his insistence and gentle but firm insistence, we're here, and we're grateful for that. But it's true. I have seen a little bit of the poverty of India. I know a lot of the statistics. I'm interested in those issues. But what I found here is I found the wealth of India. I found people that have highly educated, but have compassion and a desire to do for others in a way that I often won't find in the United States. So that's the wealth, and that's, to me, that is so powerful and so sustaining. The other thing is, what was the other point I was going to make? Or the rewards. We might come back.
I'm completely grateful for all the apparently strange coincidences that happened that got us here. I don't quite understand that I didn't know anything about Jivan Vidya. We just walked through the door after talking to Professor Sangal, and now it feels as if it was inevitable. And it feels as if we walked into this room, which is a large room, but it's not nearly as large as the scope of what was presented, the clarity of being able to feel as if I've walked into some place and all windows and doors have opened up and down and out. So I have the whole view, at least for a second, clear in my perception. And now the work of keeping the doors open and keeping the scale of things as large and as precise simultaneously as they are. And I also happen to have loved the use of language and your comment meaning about words standing for something which is whatever real. But even though I love language itself, I love the access to content that actually exists and the certainty and clarity. very indefiniteness of that, which I've spent my whole life kind of obscuring with clouds and mystery and stuff. Now I see you don't need that to have the beauty of it to be shimmering.
If you were with me just a moment, my thought came back. This is the reason why it fell out of my mind. It's the other part. The poverty of India, the wealth of India. The wealth of the United States, and the poverty of the United States. And there's a tremendous disparity and anguish and anger and frustration here in the United States that's stultified and terribly crippled. And it's something I've thought about a lot. But it came so powerfully when we talked about harmony in society. I'm thinking, good grief, of course we have issues in America. The idea of prosperity in every family, that's not terminology we use in the United States. We try to draw profits, we try to minimize, it's so evident. And so there is such a division in our society. The other thing is the fearlessness that is supposed to happen in our harmonious society. We base talk, there's a whole political structure that's based on sowing fear. And last of all, of course, we all know about the coexistence of nature. Where are we in the United States? We're paramount in discord. So, anyway, that's what I see, that's what I feel. Thank you so much.